The ocean is home to a vast diversity of life, from the very small to the very large. The animals in the ocean may share the same aquatic environment, but each species have differing life cycles and have developed specialized methods for moving through the water. Let's take a deeper look into three unique species: the jellyfish, the tuna, and the manta ray. The jellyfish may appear to be idle, easygoing animals, just drifting through the ocean waters. They may not have a brain, but they are far from simple, having evolved specialized structures to be very efficient swimmers. A lot of work has gone into making it look easy. The typical jellies we see are the adult form, called medusae. These animals have a two-part life cycle and can reproduce both sexually and asexually. For the first phase, medusae come together in large blooms to mate. They produce blob-like baby jellies called planula. These free-swimming baby jellies find a hard spot like a rock or dock to latch onto and turn into an anemone-looking form called a polyp. These polyps go through a process called strobilation, where they shed segments of their own bodies called ephyra. This is asexual reproduction. These new baby jellyfish, ephyra, then grow to become adult medusae, and the cycle begins anew. Once fully formed, jellyfish defend themselves against predators with stinging nematocysts and can capture food using structures called colloblasts. Most jellyfish eat plankton, though some large jellies will consume crustaceans, small fish, and even other jellies. They have over 100 known predators, including the ocean sunfish and leatherback turtle, the latter of which is endangered. To find prey or escape predators, jellyfish use one of their most astounding features, their unique propulsion. Although the layer of muscle used to contract the animal's body is merely one cell thick, the jellyfish has evolved extremely efficient means of moving around. Each stroke of the jellyfish's body creates a donut-shaped ring of rotating water called a stopping vortex. The second contraction creates another ring, the starting vortex, that rotates oppositely. By sucking the water into the bell and pushing the vortexes out, the jellyfish creates a jet of water, completing a style of motion called jet propulsion. This way of movement is very energy efficient because the jellyfish recaptures a lot of the energy expended to move. Because of their unique locomotive systems, jellyfish have served as a source of inspiration for efficient, long-lasting machines that can be used to monitor the health of our oceans, control invasive populations, and collect surveillance data. The jellyfish design is useful because of their efficiency, which is something scientists hope to mimic to create bots that are eco-friendly and can last long-term out in ocean waters. One of jellyfish's fastest and largest predators are tuna fish. And among tuna, bluefin are exceptionally large, with the Atlantic bluefin reaching up to 13 feet in length. These huge bodies fully develop at 8 years, which is when tunas are ready to mate. A single female can produce up to 10 million eggs in a year. Once fertilized, the eggs grow and then hatch to become tiny larvae. Tuna have a long lifespan, and these offspring will continue to roam the seas for 20, or even in some species, 40 years. Bluefin tuna are opportunistic predators and have a broad diet, but the juveniles and adults have slightly different eating habits. Juveniles favor other fish, crustaceans like crabs and shrimp, and cephalopods like squid and octopus, while the adults prefer to mostly eat fish, such as herring, anchovies, sardines, bluefish, mackerel, and more. Tuna are apex predators, but still have some threats in ocean waters. Juveniles are at risk from seabirds and bluefish, and thus travel in schools until they grow big enough to be on their own. The adults aren't completely safe either. They may still be preyed upon by sharks, marine mammals, and of course, people. Although they are massive animals, tuna still possess shocking endurance and can reach speeds of up to 90 kilometers an hour. This is due to special adaptations they have developed. Tuna have small scales that encourage a parallel, or laminar, flow of water along their bodies, reducing drag. Similarly to sharks, these fish need to swim constantly in order to breathe. This is made possible by a swimming technique referred to as tuniform. The tuna is so well known for it that the name quite literally means to swim like a tuna. Thrust is generated by the crescent-shaped caudal fin, or tail fin, which is connected to the body by a thin segment called the peduncle. The fin sways side to side while the rest of the body stays mostly still, which is why this type of swimming is also referred to as stiff-bodied. The side-to-side motion is also balanced out by other fins, including the dorsal and ventral. Pectoral fins are also used for propulsion at lower speeds and can aid maneuverability. Tuna also have a streamlined body and are one of the very few fish that are warm-blooded. This is made possible by a special circulatory structure called rhatia mirabilia. Staying warm helps them have higher heart rates, faster metabolisms, and swim faster and in colder waters. Intelligent enough to recognize their own reflections, manta rays are social animals that come in a diverse array of natural patterns, sizes, and colors. Manabirostris, the giant manta ray, is the largest within the ray group and has a wingspan of up to 7 meters wide and can weigh up to 5,300 pounds. Giant manta rays can live up to 40 years, maturing at age 5. Reproduction occurs every 2 to 3 years around rocky reefs. Mother rays give birth to 1 or 2 newborns called pups, which eventually grow into new adult rays. Manta rays are filter feeders and use the horn-like fins at the front of their bodies, called cephalic fins, to sweep planktonic organisms into their mouths. They have also been found to sometimes consume small fish. Giant manta rays have an especially unique and developed filtration system that efficiently filters small particles without clogging. The plankton is separated using a mechanism referred to as ricochet separation, which redirects excess particles so they collect towards the mouth cavity rather than forming a cake over the filter. This means their filter is kind of like if a vacuum was self-cleaning. Giant manta rays typically prefer shallow water, but have a wide range of depths at which they can swim. Able to dive 200 to 450 meters, they can even leap up to 7 feet above sea surface level. They can do this to shake off parasites when they slam their bodies against the water's surface. Unlike fish, mantas don't have typical scales, but instead have small tooth-like scales called denticles that make up their skin like sharks. These denticles act to grip the water and keep them from sliding around. Mantas are perpetual swimmers and must remain in motion in order to breathe. As they glide forward, oxygenated water is passed through their gills. This is also true for tuna and most sharks. To move, the rays flap their flattened pectoral fins up and down like a bird flaps its wings. The primary source of thrust comes from the tips of these fins. The body of the manta ray stays mostly rigid, apart from the movement of their wingtips, conserving energy. And manta rays conserve even more energy by gliding through the water. Manta rays can turn by banking, which involves a rolling movement where the ray turns on its side and is able to generate centripetal force by gliding along a curved sweeping path. Despite the range of rotational movements, the maneuverability of the ray is still limited by the size of its body and how rigid it is. Small swimmers can change direction quickly because they are more flexible and have less body to move. Think of it as the difference between a compact car making a tight turn versus a semi-truck. Although the manta ray may be less agile, it is not a major setback for this giant open ocean swimmer. For a filter feeder that collects prey rather than chases it, there isn't much need for quick turns.